In 2008, my family's circumstances changed. Me, my mom, and my sister were actually in a car accident. Thankfully, me and my sister were okay. However, my mom was in pretty rough condition. She was in a coma, and essentially the doctors told my dad everything that he needed to know to prepare for the worst. You know, it was actually in that season where we heard about the Life Church of Memphis while we were in the waiting room at the hospital. We saw Pastor John on the television in the waiting room, but we were still in that season of trying to walk through everything that my family was walking through at that time. They told us that she was probably never gonna wake up again. Well, she ended up waking up again. They told us that she was never gonna walk again. Well, she ended up walking again. And so we essentially came out of that season and we watched God do something really great through my mom, but we weren't connected to a church. But because we saw the Life Church of Memphis in the hospital waiting room, my dad said that literally God could only do this, and maybe that this is a sign that we probably need to get connected with the local church. And from there, we kind of just got plugged in. And you know, just for me personally, I was kind of hesitant to jump into Axis, you know, coming right out of fifth grade. I never really fully understood the whole church scene and you know what it really meant to live your life for God until I got plugged into Axis. That's when it kind of clicked for me. It was like, man, if I'm going to be passionate about something, being passionate about God's house is probably a good place to start. So, Axis Conference 2019, I was really stoked for it. Going into that conference, Parker sent me a text and he asked me, hey man, would you be interested in doing a 5 and 5 during one of the day sessions? And I was like, I'm doing a 5 and 5, I guess. And so I got to do a 5 and 5 at Axis Conference. That was a great moment for me, and I was so proud that, you know, my youth pastor saw that in me, that I had the capability to, you know, share a thought in front of my peers and in front of leaders, in front of, you know, guest pastors that we had at the conference. And you know, and then the last night, Pastor Charlotte Gamble, she ended up doing a message called Re-Enter the Room. And then she had an altar call at the end of her message for anybody who felt called to ministry. And that's when I first really felt the call to ministry. It was kind of just like, well, what do I do next? Like, what's next for me? So I had a conversation with Pastor Parker, and essentially he just told me, well, you know, man, we're launching Austin Peay. Man, I think you should go help Pastor Corey launch Axis out there when we launch in August. Now, I was still in high school at that point, so it was like, you know, me having the opportunity to serve alongside a youth pastor, I was really fired up for that. And then, you know, I end up graduating high school and, you know, I'm gonna just be transparent. I didn't think that, you know, even though I felt the call to full-time ministry, I assumed I wouldn't have the opportunity to do it until I was way older. But the opportunity arose at Austin Peay for me to step in and be the student coordinator at that campus. It's such a great honor to be leading Axis at the Austin Peay campus. And I'm so thankful for having leaders who believe in me. But then it's also awesome seeing the life change that's happening in some of our students' lives. You know, it's watching them take those little baby steps in working out their faith, the same steps that I had to take when I was their age, that they're taking now. And it's like, man, I'm so glad that I get to be a part of this.